Hi friends, Pastor Jesse here at Packway Evangelical Church, where we exist to help you know and follow Jesus. One of the ways that we do that here is through what you're participating in by watching this video, is through these daily read-through of scriptures so that we can be empowered and equipped to be in God's word daily for ourselves. Jesus himself tells us in John 15 that that is the absolute best way, that it's as simple, to grow in him is as simple as to be in his word and have his word tucked away in our hearts. That's how we will bear Jesus-like fruit in our lives. And so we do these read-through of scriptures. We take a chapter, we read it word for word. I leave you with an insight or two or three that the Holy Spirit highlighted for me as we read, and then we go about our days. These read-through of scriptures are not to be our daily quiet times. They're not to be our individual times before the Lord. Right now, I'm in a daily read-through of the book of Deuteronomy, but these daily read-throughs of scripture that we share here on video and on social media is to encourage us and to equip us to have our own daily time, daily place, and daily plan to meet with the Lord Jesus Christ through his word. And right now, we're gonna read through the book of Genesis. This video is in Genesis chapter 7, so you're welcome to follow along through your hearing, or open up your Bibles and follow along in Genesis chapter 7. Hear the word of the Lord. Then the Lord God said to Noah, "Go into the ark, you and all your household, for I have seen that you are righteous before me in this generation. Take with you seven pairs of all clean animals, the male and his mates, and a pair of the animals that are not clean, the male and his mate, and seven pair of birds of the heavens also, male and female, to keep their offering alive in the face of all the earth. For in 7 days I will send rain on the earth, 40 days and 40 nights, and every living thing that I have made I will blot out from the face of the ground." And Noah did all that the Lord had commanded him. Noah was 600 years old when the flood waters came up on the earth. And Noah and his wife and his sons' wives with them went into the ark to escape the waters of the flood. Of clean animals and of animals that are not clean, and of the birds and of everything that creeps on the ground, two and two, male and female, went into the ark with Noah as God had commanded Noah. And after 7 days, the waters of the flood came up upon the earth. In the 600th year of Noah's life, in the second month, on the 7th day of the month, on that day all the fountains of the great deep burst forth and the windows of the heavens were opened. And rain fell upon the earth 40 days and 40 nights. On the very same day, Noah and his sons Shem and Ham and Japheth and Noah's wife and the three wives of his sons with them entered into the ark. They and every beast according to its kind, and all the livestock according to their kinds, and every creeping thing that creeps on the earth according to its kind, and every bird according to its kind, every winged creature. They went into the ark with Noah, two and two of all flesh, in which there was the breath of life. And those that entered, male and female of all flesh, went in as God had commanded him, and the Lord shut them in. The flood continued 40 days on the earth. The waters increased and bore up the ark, and it rose high above the earth. The waters prevailed and increased greatly on the earth, and the ark floated on the face of the waters. And the waters prevailed so mightily on the earth that all the high mountains under the whole heaven were covered. The waters prevailed above the mountains, covering them 15 cubits deep. And all flesh died that moved on the earth, birds, livestock, beasts, and all swarming creatures that swarm on the earth, and all mankind. Everything on the dry land, and whose nostrils was the breath of life, died. He blotted out every living thing that was on the face of the ground, man and animals and creeping things and birds of the heavens. They were blotted out from the earth. Only Noah was left and those who were with him inside the ark, and the waters prevailed on the earth for 150 days. This is the word of the Lord in Genesis chapter 7, I should say here. And we can wonder, why did God send such a flood like this, destroying all mankind that was not in that boat? But again, it is to show us, and it's a picture of how sinful humanity is. And if it's hard for us to see, because we don't want to see ourselves as a part of the sinful humanity, we don't want to admit how sinful we are. But if we take an honest look at the world that is around us, we don't have to look to the history books, we don't have to look to what is coming in the future and predict what is coming, but we can look to ourselves, we can look to our own world that we live in and see that it is a sinful and deprived humanity. You open the news feed of your phone, you open and turn on the news on the TV, you see heinous and horrible things happening, not just in foreign nations and in foreign places, but right here at home. We take an honest look at our lives and see that we are a sinful and a heinously sinful people. The thoughts that fill our mind, again, Jesus says that it's not just the act of murder, it's not just the act of committing adultery with a husband or wife that is not our own. It's the thought of those things. It's lusting after a woman. It's hating a brother or sister that is sin. and we think about our thoughts, and we think about the actions that come through our thoughts, and we will honestly see that we are a sinful humanity. And God, in this moment, he decided to start fresh, to find a righteous man in Noah, a man who was willing and voluntarily following his ways, to restart through that man and to restart his creation. And of course, we know that even restarting through Noah, a righteous man, we know that immediately, I'll give you a spoiler alert, what is coming in the coming chapters through Noah himself and through his sons is more sin and more sinful acts of mankind. But God in his wisdom, God in his sovereignty, decided to restart here, to restart through sending floodwaters to relentlessly flood the earth, to take away life from all things that were not on that ark, and to begin anew. And we have to trust that God, through his sovereignty, and we have to understand that God, that through our sinfulness, we are not promised and should not be promised our next breath, that God will do in his good and his sovereign ways as he determines best to be good and sovereign. So we trust in him for that. And we see even in his grace here that he actually provides, he takes food for all those that are on the boat, and he takes male and female, two by two, all of living creatures, and he preserves them, and he will eventually restore them and multiply them once the floodwaters recede on the earth. Our God is good, our God is kind, our God is loving, and our God is a God of redemption. And we see that most clearly through the flood and through his work, through a righteous man named Noah and his acts of faith and obedience. Thank you for joining us today as we read through Genesis chapter 7. Next time, we'll be in Genesis chapter 8 and see how God unveils his story of redemption, his new covenant, his new promise to Noah and to all mankind. We'll see you then.